Hey guys, welcome back to my humming home. I'm Shweta. This is surprisingly a fun fact that our day begins and ends with the washrooms, isn't it? In this video, I'm going to share my weekly cleaning routine. Let's start with clearing up all the surfaces. Put everything inside a laundry basket and keep it out of the washroom so that you get all the countertops and your floor area all clear to be cleaned. I start with the cleaning of wash basin and the mirror. I use Jif and a normal Scotch Brite for cleaning up the surface. Take a little on the scrubber and start scrubbing. Leave it for a while after you scrub it. People who follow me on Instagram know that I have recently moved to a new house. And just see in what condition I have found the wash basin. It looks like a splatter of dye or something. If you know any hacks to clean it, please let me know in the comment box. These were hard water stains on the tap, which I cleaned up with a mixture of baking soda and lemon juice. This is an electrical cleaning brush. If you are interested, check the description box. I will leave the link there. Just take a microfiber cloth and rub it all around the surface and you are good to go. I usually clean my mirrors with water vinegar solution, but I ran out of vinegar, so this time only water. Now comes the bathtub. Again same Jif and scrubber. Let's clean the shower caddy first. Being kept in the shower area, this caddy has the maximum possibility of catching molds. So cleaning it weekly gives it a good cleanup and gives it a good shine. And it hardly takes 2 minutes. Now scrubbing the bathtub. Trust me guys, when I say clean washroom is an addiction, it is. Once you start cleaning your washroom regularly, it's very, very difficult for you or your family members to use a dirty washroom. And it's hygienic also, right? This is a new shower head we got installed in the washroom just because of simple reason. Who doesn't like healthy skin and healthy hairs? This shower head is supposed to remove 99% of harmful water pollutants and make your skin feel soft because it removes chlorine, lead, nickel and so many chemicals from the water which are not needed. I'll leave a link in the description box, you can check if you are interested. For the toilets, I use these Harpic Flushmatics which are very easy and convenient to use. One block lasts up to 1 month. It doesn't let any stains remain on the surface. Just a scrub with the toilet brush and you are done. Now for the flush tank, the other surfaces of the pot, I prefer to use toilet paper and avoid microfiber cloths just to avoid any cross contamination. Use the paper and throw it in the pot, flush it and sort it. I usually vacuum the floor every alternate days, but on weekly basis, I wash the floors. Use a simple squeegee to squeeze out all the water and you won't believe from every nook and corner, I don't know how some or the other piece of dirt comes out. After removing all the extra water from the floor, take an old cloth and wipe it. Now is the time to put everything back at its place. Here goes the laundry bag. This is a storage cabinet which I really want to replace. Switch on the exhaust, open the curtains, and leave everything to get dry so that you can enjoy a nice, neat and clean washroom. Hope you like this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my humming home. See you next time. Bye-bye.